If you use Canva to design for your business, today I have 5 tips and tricks that I know that you love that I have learned over the last couple of years. So let's not waste any time. Let's jump into the Canva dashboard and let's get started. Okay, so the first tip that I want to show you is graphics, because I find that small business owners who are not designers struggle with finding consistency in their graphics. So the first tip will be, if you're using the graphics from Canva, so let's go ahead, you know what, the holidays are coming, so let's go ahead and try some Christmas decorations. Let's just go with this cute Christmas tree here. All right, so this Christmas tree here, it's really cutesy, childlike graphic, right? So one of the things that you can do to stay consistent with the graphics is either one, you can go with the magic recommendation based on this graphic. And so if you click on that, it'll give you graphics that are very similar in style to this particular one. So as you can see here, the Christmas tree, and this is, what is this, bamboo? All right, so you see how the design is very similar to that one. Another thing that you could do is you can click on the info tab here and you can do see more like this, right? So you can click on that and it will give you more graphics that are similar to that. A third option would be to click on the information and then click on the designer who created that graphic. All right. And so this, so because that most likely, right, they're going to have graphics that are similar because they created it. So then you can go on here and this is all of the graphics that are designed by the same designer. Okay. And what you can do here is search even further. And so this particular search bar is just for this particular designer only. So we go ahead and click on Christmas and then it'll search for all of the Christmas graphics for this particular designer. And you can browse through here. And as you can see, this particular one doesn't have too many. He just has the, these three here, but this is a way that you can search graphics so that you can stay consistent. The second tip that I want to show you is with text. So let's go ahead and continue with this this cute Christmas tree. And when you're on the design, a shortcut key in Canva is to click on the letter T for text, and the text will come up for you here. Okay, so let's go in here and let's just type in Christmas. And let's go ahead, and the newer design is a lot of warp text and things like that. So let's go ahead and create that here. All right. So let's move this up here. All right. And then if you click on effects, we know that you have these particular effects already available to you on Canva, right? So you can go ahead and curve that. And there are different ways that you can curve it. Size of the curve, you see, this is how you use this curve here. Okay. So those are ways that you can curve it here. The new that I see a lot recently is the warp, right? And how do you do that? As you can see, you can't do it from here. And so that warp effect is actually, you have to come to the app section and then you can scroll down. Now I have it here, but if you don't have it, you can just type it in the TypeCraft, okay? Instead of actually typing the word in the design, you actually type, we're gonna type Christmas right in here. We're going to type Christmas right in here. All right. And it's not going to type it directly in here. So we're actually going to be working on this section here, right? So here's the Christmas. And then you have select fonts that you could use from here. Okay. So let's go ahead and just use that one and see how that will look. Okay. And then you have these styles are still available. So you have the none, you have unfilled, the outline, and you can go ahead and just change those colors there for you. And then what you can do here is how you start to create that warped effect. All right, so you grab those little circles and you start to move the circles around. All right, and you see that effect there. It does take some time, so I do want you to take your time doing this because there's a little bit of a learning curve, as you can see. But that is, let's say you want to warp it that way, right? And then you, what you'll do, how you add it to design is right here. Once you're done with it, you can click on add element to the design and it will add it right in there. And then you can come in here and then make it the size that you want it to be. Okay, so that is one way that you can do the warp. If you find, you know what, you're not sure that you're liking that, you have to just come back right over here and continue to work on that design, from that text design from right in here. Okay. However you want to do it, and then update the element and it'll update it there. Okay. So unlike this text here, where you create all of the modifications in here, with the TypeCraft, you actually do all of the modifications right in here. Okay. So you just click on it and then make whatever changes you want to make from right in here, and then make those updates there. While we're on the topic of font, the next tip is also with these words as well. So let's go ahead and click on Christmas, and let's try the new Canva Magic for Morph. So this was released just a few weeks ago. So let's go ahead and click on back to apps, and then you can just type in Morph, and then here it is. All right. So I already have selected the Christmas. So that's what's selected here. And then let's go ahead, and you have to give it a prompt, right? So let's go ahead and make that into, let's try peppermint, and let's see what we get. This is really, really fun. It's gonna take a little bit to generate. So it's like generating an AI image, right? It takes a little bit of time, and let's see what comes up. It's gonna give me four options. The cool thing about this new Canva warp is that it can do text and it can do icons. So no, it didn't like peppermint. Okay, that's cool. Let's try the pumpkin. It already has a Halloween pumpkin. Let's go ahead and just try that, just so you can see.
3 days later.
Oh no, it's having some tech issues. Okay, not a problem. Let's go ahead and try it again.
1 eternity later.
Let's go ahead and delete that. And let's try it again. And let's go ahead and look for a nice big font. Good old fashioned Anton. Let's try that now. Let's see what we get. So let's go ahead and see if changing to a nice chunky font, if that makes a difference here.
Eventually.
Okay, so I got something. All right, let's try these out. Let's go ahead and delete all of this back here. All right, let's see what I got. Not too bad. Let's see what this one looks like. That one's cute if I like, you know, if I wanted flowers. All right, so go ahead and give this one a try. Again, it is still new and it is AI, so we have to be a little bit patient. So that is a new Magic Morph from Canva. Now, tip number four, is if you have the free Canva, you're only able to upload one brand kit. So if you want to make changes to your current design to make it holiday theme, right? You don't want to redesign everything that you already have. What you can do is you can grab a color palette from maybe Pinterest or any other website that has color combinations. And what you'll do is just copy and paste and bring that color palette right into the design. And what you'll do is you'll right click and apply colors, and it will grab colors from that palette and apply it to the design. Isn't that cool? So you can go ahead and just continue to do that until you get the combination that you like. Now the background to this won't change because it's an image, but you can go ahead and continue to do that. So it's much, much easier than having to click on each element and change the color. All right. And you can also, let me remove that. And you can also do this with an image as well. So let's go ahead and click on this image here. Let's go ahead and just make this really small here, and it can do the same thing as the color palette. It can pull colors from this image. So again, you can right click, apply colors. Voila. Isn't that cool? Such a time saver. I could be here for hours. Okay. All right. Let's go on to the tip number five. Now, my last tip, it is my favorite tip. When I figured this out, it was like winning the lottery. So it has to do with mockups, right? So on this particular mockup, because I don't have it in the direction where it's supposed to be, right? So this mockup is actually supposed to look like this, right? That's how the direction we have the sky up here and then the grass down here, right? So when you import an image, it puts the image where it's supposed to be, right? However, because I don't want the mockup to be this direction, I want it to be like this. And I enter and I put in this image, it's going to be the wrong direction, right? So what you need to do is what you have to do is actually grab the image and turn the image and then insert it into the mockup. Ta-da! I'm super excited. I love this hack and I just wanted to share it with you. Were you aware of these tricks? Let me know in the comments below which one you're going to try out first. If you want to see more Canva tutorials, I have these two where I show you how to recreate popular graphics in Canva. Adios.